हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, माय नेम इज निर्भय जाधव एंड आई एम हियर टू टीच यू फिजिक्स। दिस लेक्चर इज फॉर द स्टूडेंट्स हु हैव जस्ट पास्ड आउट फ्रॉम द फिफ्थ स्टैंडर्ड एंड हैज केम टू द सिक्स्थ स्टैंडर्ड। नाउ इन सिक्स्थ स्टैंडर्ड यू हैव स्टडीड अ सब्जेक्ट कॉल्ड साइंस। नाउ इन सिक्स्थ स्टैंडर्ड दिस सब्जेक्ट हैज बीन डिवाइडेड इन टू थ्री पार्ट्स, दैट इज फिजिक्स, केमिस्ट्री एंड बायोलॉजी। सो इन दिस लेक्चर आई एम गोना टीच यू फिजिक्स। ओके, सो in this lecture I am not going to start with the chapter, I will just introduce you to the physics and I will let you know that why physics is important in our life and where the physics is applicable in our life. Okay, so let us begin. So basically the revolution of the planets around the sun as and also rotation on its own axis, and because of that we are having a day and night. There is also a change in the climate, we are having a different season like winter, summer, monsoon. So this all thing is relatable to the physics. Okay, so basically we can say that physics is nothing but a nature. Okay, so I hope you are clear that what is physics. Now I will let you know that where physics is applicable in our life. So as soon as you wake up in the morning, what is the first thing you do? You take a shower, right? So when you take a shower, after taking a shower, when you come out, you will observe that there is a few droplets of water on your body. So these droplets of water is not because of the just because you have taken a shower, it is because of the exchange of energy. When you pour a cold liquid, say water, on your body and your body temperature is 37 degree Celsius, so there is a difference in temperature, right? And because of this difference in the temperature, the our body has a pores, and out of that pores the droplets comes out. So you can relate it to the physics. If you are not able to understand this example, you can also relate this example to this example which is shown on your screen. So that is a glass in which a cold liquid is poured. So when you pour a cold liquid into the glass, what happens? You will see there is a droplets of water surrounded on it. Have you seen that? Again, that is the same thing, that is the exchange of energy. So when you pour a cold liquid into the glass, and see, the temperature of the liquid is very low while the surrounding temperature is comparatively high. So because of the difference in the temperature, there is an exchange of heat energy. So as a result, what happens? The warm air on the surrounding, it condenses on the surface of the vessel. So that is, you can see on the figure, that is obviously you have also observed in your practical life. Okay, so this both the examples, you can say that again the physics is applied. So now you have taken the shower. Now what will you do? You will do the next thing, that is you will prepare a tea or a coffee for you, right? So again, for the recipe of making a tea or coffee, again you are going to apply physics in that. So when you want to make a tea, what you will do, you will take a pan and you pour a water into it, you on your stove, pour a liquid into it, put a sugar and a tea inside it. Okay, now again, you know that the recipe of a tea, right? You don't pour a milk into it directly, you will wait until and unless it gets a boil into it. So again, getting a boil, after getting a boil you are gonna pour a milk into it. So again, in that point also you are using a physics. Okay, so now your tea is ready. When you come out taking your tea into the balcony, what you observe, that it is raining, right? Obviously it is a monsoon season, so it is raining and you are enjoying your tea or coffee with a rainy season. And suddenly what you see, a droplets of water. Can you say me that what is the shape of the droplets of water? Is this a rectangle, triangle or any arbitrary shape? No, it is a spherical shape. Again, there is a physics behind it, that is known as a surface tension. You will learn this surface tension in the higher classes. But again, the spherical shape of a water droplets is again depends on the physics. Okay, so now what you see, there is a rain, droplets of water, you are enjoying your tea or coffee, and suddenly what you see is that from the one side the sun has emerged out. So there is a clouds, there is a rain, also the sun. So as a result, obviously we are going to get a rainbow, right? So presence of the sun, cloud and the water droplet, as a result we'll get a rainbow. So again, the formation of rainbow is also a physics. Now we'll learn that how the rainbow is formed. When the white light will pass from the droplet of the water, that white light will split into the seven colors. That is a vibgyor, okay, that we called as a spectrum. So you will also learn this in the higher class, taking a prism. Say when you pass a white light from the prism, that white light splits into the different seven colors. That is a spectrum. You can see that the violet color is at the bottom while the red color is on the top. Again, if I say that again, the physics is there behind this. Say violet color is having a high energy, that is why it bends more, while the red color is having the lowest energy, as a result it doesn't bends more comparatively to the violet color. Say if I use the physics language, I'll say that the wavelength of violet color is very less compared to the wavelength of a red color. So if I give you the example, say if you're not able to understand what is the wavelength, can you say me that what is the tail light of your vehicle? Is that a violet or a red? Obviously it is a red, because the wavelength of a red color is high. So from far distance you can observe the red color. Okay, so we are not going to discuss about the frequency wavelength. We'll keep this simple because it is only the starting point. Okay, so we are not going that much in detail. Okay, next. So now you are sitting in the front of your screen, right? You are able to see that screen. So there are two types of object. First is the luminous object and second is the non-luminous object. The photo, or say the image in the screen, you can see that is a sun, right? So sun has its own light. So can we say that it is a luminous object because it has its own light? But what about this object, that is a moon? Okay, moon doesn't have its own light. Still we are able to see the moon because of the reflection of a light. So there are two kind of objects. One is a luminous object which has its own light, and the second one is the object which doesn't have its own light, that is known as a non-luminous object. Now how we are able to see the non-luminous object? That is a very simple, that is a reflection of light. Can you see the image on the screen? The sun is there, the light of the sun incident on the tree, and after that incidence it gets reflected and enter into our eye. As a result, we are able to see the object which doesn't have its own light. Okay, so now the next thing, if I say many of you are taking a selfie, right? Have you observed that when you, after taking a selfie, you will see the photo or say image, it is inverted. So that is known as a lateral inversion. See this panda or say Minnie the Pooh is in front of you. If you see the image, we can see his left hand, he is shaking his left hand, while if we see the image in the mirror, you can see that it is its right hand. So that is known as a lateral inversion. You can also compare it with this example. See, the P is written, okay, on the right hand side, what the P you see is the correct one, while on the other side it is totally inverted. So that is in a lateral inversion. That is also nothing but a physics. Okay, now sound. At present you are sitting in the front of the mobile, maybe you are using the hands-free, or say you are communicating with your friends, or you are communicating at your home with your parents. So I will explain now how the sound travels and how it reaches to your eardrum. Say you went to temple, right? So when you came out from the temple, you saw the array of beggars were sitting. What you did? You gave a 5 rupee coin to the first beggar. Now, taking the 5 rupee coin, that beggar became very happy. And after observing that, the second beggar who was sitting next to him also became happy, because he was knowing that next was his turn. So like that, what happens? The third beggar also started jumping, because he also came to know, okay, someone is there who is giving them a money. Likewise, the beggar who was sitting at the end of the temple also started jumping. So what you did? You didn't give the 5 rupee coin to the last beggar. You gave the 5 rupee coin only to the first beggar. But still that energy was passed to the last beggar. Same thing happens in the sound also. When you give energy to the first particle, what happens? That energy is transferred to the second particle. Okay, now this second particle is vibrating and it passes energy to the third particle. Likewise, the energy is transmitted from one particle to the another particle. Remember, the particles are not moving, they are only just transferring the energy. As you can see in this object, the particles are at their own position. The energy is transferred, okay? And it is transferred, and this process is very fast. And at the last, that energy reaches up to your eardrum. As a result, you are able to hear the sound, okay? So that is again a physics. Now, the last example I would like to take, that is a potential energy and kinetic energy. When the object is at rest, you can see in the screen that the object, when it is rest on the top of the slope, it is having a potential energy. As soon as it starts moving and comes down to the inclined plane, its body starts moving, and say the body possesses kinetic energy. Let us take one more example. Look at this roller coaster. When the roller coaster is traveling up, it is having a kinetic energy. When it comes to the middle top of the roller coaster, it's having a potential energy. Again, when it's coming down, again it possesses a kinetic energy. Same, lot of you are playing a PUBG, right? So when you jump out from the plane, so you are moving downwards, right? It means your body is moving and your body possesses a kinetic energy. Now, as soon as you open your parachute and land on the ground, your body comes to rest. It means your body is possessing a potential energy. I hope we have discussed enough example related to physics. And in the next lecture, we are going to start with the first chapter, that is a matter. Stay connected. Thank you very much for looking this video completely. Give a like and subscribe. Thank you.